This is Purdue University's Reactor Number 1. It is Indiana's first and only nuclear reactor, originally built in 1962. For its first 54 years, it was licensed at 1 kilowatt, but will move to 10 kilowatt operation during 2017. The reactor is a central piece to the research and teaching mission of the School of Nuclear Engineering at Purdue. The reactor sits at the bottom of a 17-foot deep pool. The water makes the reactor run, provides coolant for the hot fuel, and shields operators from the radiation. The reactor runs on a plate-type fuel, which is a uranium silicide matrix encased in aluminum. The fuel plates are about 60 centimeters or 2 feet tall, a couple inches across, and are placed together in assemblies. This is an older demonstration assembly. The assemblies are filled with fuel plates and placed at the bottom of the pool in the reactor core. The reactor is officially classified as a materials test reactor, which means its purpose is to provide benchmark testing for candidate materials to be used in industrial settings. Today, we continue to use it to test materials, perform basic research, and educate Purdue University undergraduate and graduate students, as well as the public, about nuclear energy. These are our original instrumentation racks, which monitor the power level and period of the reactor. The reactor was built by the Lockheed Nuclear Corporation in 1962 and features state-of-the-art technology of the time. Yes, that includes vacuum tubes. The operator console provides all the information the operator needs for the safe operation of PUR-1, including the enunciators, rod height, power level, time, and emergency numbers to call. The enunciator panels give information to the operators of the status of various parts of the system. If there is a reactor shutdown, one or more of the tiles will indicate the cause of the shutdown. When the reactor is starting up, operators reference channel 1 to see the counts from a special detector called a fission chamber. The fission chamber shows from 1 to 10,000 counts per second. It also feeds a low-power period circuit. Unfortunately, looking at dials and meters only gives an instantaneous measurement. Sometimes operators need to see how a value has changed over time, so they use the chart recorders shown here for channel 1. The red line shows us coming down from high power after shutting down. The reactor is started by turning on magnets, which lift the control rods out of the core using 3 different screw drives. The magnet power is carefully controlled and managed with this box. The current, and therefore force of attraction of the magnets, is reduced at higher powers. When the power gets too high, the magnets are no longer able to hold the rods up. When they fall into the core, the reactor shuts down. These dials provide additional indication of the reactor's power and the period. As the value increases, a contact switch can be closed and the reactor will shut down. Multiple instruments can shut off the reactor for any number of the important things we measure. This is the reactor's coolant processing system. Our water chemistry is very carefully maintained to ensure the integrity of the components submerged in the pool. In fact, our facility could operate continuously for over 150 years with the current amount of fuel. Our lifetime is dictated by the degradation from the water. The pH and conductivity of the water must meet regulatory requirements and is checked weekly. Water passes through a deionizing cartridge, a demineralizer, as well as a heat exchanger, which is shell and tube type and helps us keep the water at lower temperatures. Radiation monitors are placed around the facility to ensure dose levels remain safe. We rarely see elevated doses, and an alarm will sound if doses rise too high. Radiation levels are also shown on the instrument racks so that the operators can see the current level without having to leave their post at the console. Anything that goes near the reactor core gets mapped on this plate. Here, you can see the ones with a letter and a number show fuel. SS1, SS2, and RR are the control rods. G and I are for the graphite reflector, and S is for our startup source. There is a lot of maintenance to be done at the reactor. We keep detailed logs to make sure we stay on time, on track, and on target. Our operators are licensed by the Nuclear Regulatory Commission. Most of the time, PUR-1 has three licensed operators. We are very excited about the future of the PUR-1 reactor. In 2016, a new all-digital instrumentation and control system was purchased. Designed by Mirion Technologies and Scientech Corporation, the new instrumentation and controls will enable the staff to take high-fidelity data and allow many more teaching tools for the Nuclear Engineering Department. The new system must be licensed by the Nuclear Regulatory Commission and will allow Purdue to produce elite engineers and perform important research for many years to come.